In this lecture, we will discuss about builder design pattern. Builder design pattern is used to create complex objects in steps with different representations. Okay, let's see the intent of builder pattern. Separate the construction of a complex object from its representation so that the same construction process can create different representations. So we have two things. Separate the construction of a complex object from its representation so that the same construction process can create different representations. Okay, let's have a thought process for a problem and how we will come up with the solution. Okay, so we have an ID and we want to see the project. Project can be seen in project view or class view. Project view will have files to show and class view will have classes to show. There may be more, like method view to show methods, data member view to show data members. There can be combination too, like class view and method view together to show the classes and methods of classes. Okay, so we require project, and project will have different parts like project name, files, classes, methods, data members. So it is simple. We can have view manager which creates project. But the project has multiple parts and different views of project require different representations. Like project view will require project name and files, class view will require project name and classes, and so on for others. In fact, we are building composite object. Okay, let's stick to project view and class view only. So what we see? It is becoming complex for view manager to have the construction logic and the creation of object together. Also, there are many views and different representation of project. So we would like to have construction logic separate from the creation of project object. So the same construction logic can be used for building the different representation of object. Okay, so we can have view creator and view builder. View creator will have logic for construction of object with different parts. View builder will create the parts of project object and assemble them to form a project object. Good, but again it will be too complex to create different representations of project object in view builder with more and more views and combination of parts. Okay, so we will have one builder for each view, like project view builder for project view and class view builder for class view, and others can be in the same way. But then view creator will require to know about project view builder, class view builder, and it will become complex to add new builders. Okay, so we will have view builder interface and view creator will just use it in the construction logic. The project view builder and class view builder will be derived from view builder and will implement its interfaces to build the parts of object and will assemble all the parts to create different representation of project object. Now this looks good, as we can just add another builder class if one more different view is required. I have created UML diagram for this. The class view creator has logic for construction of project. It has instance of view builder. It gets the information of parts of the project. Then it requests the view builder to build the parts of project. View builder has interfaces for building the parts of project and assembling it. Project view builder and class view builder are derived classes and implement the interfaces of view builder for different representation of project. So project view builder builds the parts of project and assemble it for representation of project view, and class view builder builds the parts of project and assemble it for representation of class view. View builder provides the interface to get the project object. This interface is implemented by project view builder and class view builder. So here a complex composite object is built step by step and the product is returned in the final step. The good thing is that it isolates the code for construction and representation. So we can see that the logic for construction of object is separated from the representation of object. We are using same construction process for different representation of object. Congratulations, you have gone through a thought process and have come up with a design solution for a problem. Okay, let's see the structure of builder design pattern. It will give you good understanding of participant classes, relationship between classes, and how all of them work together. Okay, let's see the participant classes. We have abstract class builder. It provides interfaces for creating parts of object. The concrete class concrete builder is derived from builder. It implements the methods of builder for creating parts of object. This assembles the parts to make a final product. It has the representation of objects and provides the interface to get the created object. We have class director. It has builder as aggregation. It uses builder interface for constructing the object. We have class product. It represents object to be created. Okay, let's see how they will work together. Client uses the director and provides the information for the product it wants to create. Director has construction logic based on the provided information and uses builder interface to create parts of object. Concrete builder methods create the part of the object and assemble them for a required product. The builder provides the product to client through its interface. So you can see, construction process is separated from representation of object. The internal structure of object is not known to the outside world as it is with concrete builder only. Builder interface hides the representation and internal structure of the product. It also hides how the product gets assembled. The construction process has a way to create object in parts and is well managed by director. The same construction process is used to create different representations of product. Okay, let's see some modifications and variations applied here. New representation of object will require adding new concrete builder which can be easily added. Also, it will be easy to modify the construction logic and representation of objects. We just have to add the new builder for changing the product's internal representation, because product is constructed through an abstract interface. Some scenarios may require access to intermediate object and has to be taken care through builder. You can see there is no interface for product, as final objects will be quite different and also well known to client as it provides the input. Different directors can reuse the same set of parts to build the variants of product. We can have another director which can use the same builder interface to create the product. Builder has all the methods for creating parts of object, so the required ones have to be implemented in concrete builder. But you can have variation like default implementation too. So where it can be applicable? When a complex object has to be created in steps, as we have seen earlier, a composite project object. Same construction process of object is required to provide different representation of final object. So construction logic is same, but object has many representations. The construction process requires separation from representation. So it will be easy to have a new representation or new construction process.